Hello everyone, this is Kalyan from BlackBox Tech, and today I will discuss about a hot topic, and it's about Monorepo. And we'll also discuss how you can take the same approach in our Angular project, and within a single workspace you will have all your software together, sharing data between each other. So first thing first, what is Monorepo? Monorepo is a workspace or a source control pattern where all your developed software will stay in place. Rather than maintaining multiple repos for individual software, you will have a single source of truth, and also it will help sharing data between each other. Google maintains this approach, and you can have a look of that by going Angular Git repo as well. So without any further delay, let's jump in to see how we can manage our Angular workspace in the same way. So first step is to create a blank workspace. For that, you can simply use power of Angular CLI. I will use ng new command along with create application flag to do that. Now, inside the workspace, you can use ng generate to generate multiple apps and libraries. The solution did not end up here. Now let's see how we can overcome few of the issues we face going with this approach. Let's generate our first application. It will update the angular.json file with an entry of application and set it as a default project. You can generate multiple applications with the same process. Now let's generate a library which will be shared across multiple applications within your enterprise. Now you can ask me how this library will be shared across multiple apps, and tsconfig plays a vital role for this. You can see it's already created a path entry, so it will always resolve from this directory once you build the library. This library needs to be built first, so it will be available for all the apps you create. Let's create a script config for that in package.json and build the library. Now once that is built, I will now use this library in our main application. Now, just test it out. I will also create a script entry which will build all the apps. You can also lint your app using ng-lint to check for errors, and if you want, you can also extend your tslint to use any other lint best practices, for an example Airbnb tsconfig, to get better coverage of best practices. Now, what about helping developers to check in only the tested code, and in case of the code is not tested or if it's not covered of set of standard coverage percentage, it will restrict the code to check in the repo. Now, let's work towards that setup. If you run the ng test now, it will start running the unit test for all the projects. One thing you notice that the Chrome browser will remain open and it will not quit even the test completes. This is good for debugging, but if we use this as a pre-commit hook, you don't want this to happen. So one of the solutions to fix this by changing single run to true. Before that, let's fix this unit test error by adding the missing dependency. Now let's change the karma config and change the single run to true. Now create a script again which will run the test cases and also generate a coverage report. If you run the newly created script, you will be able to see in coverage folder it creates two folder, but hey, we don't want two separate report. We just want single consolidated report in one place. Let's fix this issue by again changing some config in your karma config file. I will simply change the reports to JSON from HTML. So all our test cases will generate reports as JSON. Now the second thing, we have to make sure it makes the individual JSON to generate a single HTML report. For this, I will use a module called Istanbul Combine. I will create a scripts folder and will create a file called merge-reports.js and paste the code. Our file name is coverage-final.json. Let's change the pattern in the script as for file name, and the wildcard will check for this pattern in all the folders for you. Let's install the module first before running as dev dependency. Now test the script to check the solution. It should merge all our individual report and generate a single HTML report. Now let's add this to our package.json script. The next thing we will do to prettify our code before check-in, and for that I will use a schematic. I have this installed globally, so I'll just install the schematic in my workspace. Now let's see what all things it's added in our package.json apart from other files. It's created a pre-commit hook using husky, which will help us to add our test script inside that. So before check-in, it will first run our test cases. Also, it will prettify your staged files. This is only for staged file, but it also added a new script which you can run to get your all files prettified. Let's try that. Now I will add our test script within this pre-commit hook to restrict code check-in without running unit test cases. Apart from this, I will also add the threshold values within karma config to make sure the commit will fail if the unit test case coverage not met 80%. Now, if I try to commit, it will run all the things for you. Thanks a lot for watching, and don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. Have a great weekend ahead.